Are we fed up doing accessibility testing manually due to lot of actions available in web-based applications or applications? Are you not able to generate the dashboards? If you are struggling with these two issues, you are at the right place. I'm going to cover one of the most used applications for accessibility testing, where everything will be done automatically from creations of accessibility report after the executions, as well as generating detailed accessibility issues in the website. Welcome to RaiGoogle.com. Myself Deepak Rai. I am the technology trainer at this channel. If you are looking forward to learn about software testing, automations, project management, as well as web development, don't forget to subscribe and hit bell icon. Whenever I will upload a new technical topics video, it will get notified to you. Going back to the topic, where I'm going to cover Lighthouse applications, which is built by Google for performing automatic accessibility testing. After the testing, it will also generate detailed dashboards or detailed report, which can be shared with your superiors after testing. If you wanted to learn in detail, don't skip a little part of the video as well. Otherwise, you might miss important concept. If you wanted to learn any other tool for accessibility testing, please add the tool name in comment. We'll be happy to cover that tool in detail. Let's go and start using Lighthouse for accessibility. For that, you need to have admin permissions. Go to Google Web Store and just add Lighthouse. Search Lighthouse extensions. Add into your Chrome browser. It will pop up add extensions. Now it's done. We have this icon added successfully. Perfect. After adding this, you might have to restart your browser. Let me restart. Here, I will go to my account and then we'll open any website. Let me open US government site, US government portal, usa.gov, and try to see the accessibility of this applications. Simply, I will go to this. You'll get this pop-up window. You can locate to your original locations and what device you're using. As of now, I'm using desktop and I wanted to use Lighthouse Viewer, which should perform just accessibility because it's also available for best practices, SEO, accessibility, as well as performance. For our purpose, I wanted to just do accessibility testing for the site. We'll click on generate report. It will take fraction of seconds to generate detailed report for the particular page. Let's wait for the load and now you can see how perfect this website is. Accessibility is getting 100% score, which involves interactive controls or keyboards focusable. It's enabled. Interactive elements indicate their purpose and state that is also. These are the category which it is highlighted. Here you have past edits. You can see area tabs are properly used. Area hidden, roles, documentations, HTML tag, lang, everything is used properly. And that's the main reason Lighthouse is giving 100% score for this website. I will do similar check for any e-commerce portal. Consider we have e-commerce portal Walmart. I wanted to do the testing or do the accessibility of this one. We'll go to extensions, open this Lighthouse Viewer. And here we have generate report. It will scan the entire page which is open on the screen and generate the report. But when we are using Lighthouse, whichever page is open, it will perform the accessibility testing for that particular page. If you wanted to do everything in bulk, we do have some alternatives, which is the paid versions. This is an open source tool provided by the Google, where you can do accessibility testing for each of the page one by one. Similarly, you can also perform accessibility testing
for your mobile applications or devices. Interesting thing is, for Walmart.com, it provided a score of 96. And what's the issues we can see? All department, terms of use, store directory, these icons or these links are not touch target with sufficient size and spacing help user who may have difficult targeting small controls to activate. So this is coming under guidelines of WCAG protocol, and that's main reason it gave us this one. These are the issues because of that we are getting 96% of score. If you wanted to see more details, we can have this one where you can see these are the past criteria, which these all are not applicable. Then the past audit, these all are audits. Let's try it out with other applications as well. Maybe I will target for some random applications which does not have the accessibility in place. For that, maybe we can target for any website which is dummy. So here I will just use, let me do accessibility for this one. Close this. Now I wanted to perform the accessibility. Generate report PSI front end. It will generate a page speed insight, which even we can copy the link or download it. This is still running. The dynamic performance issues, everything is running. But here, in terms of core web vital assessments, it's failed, where we can have largest contentful paint. That's one issue. Interactive to next paint, that is 95. Cumulative layout shift is 0.13. So let's wait for this to finish and then we'll have a look. So when we are using Lighthouse, it will have two folds. One, you can directly analyze it with the Lighthouse. A second, you can go to the page speed insights and this will generate a detailed dashboards, which you can see it accurately here. Now, coming back to the accessibility, this possesses the accessibility of 90%, where background or foreground color do not have sufficient contrast ratio, which is one of the WCAG guidelines. And that's the reason it fails. If the color code are almost same or similar, it means background or foreground colors codes are similar, that's where it will also show the issues. Select elements do not have associated level elements. That's other issues. Navigations heading elements are not in sequential descending order. That's where other issues. Because of these issues, it's giving the percentage of 96. However, we can have layout issues. Avoid large layout shift, eliminate render blocking. These all issues which is given in detail. At any point of time you wanted to share this report, you can just copy link and share on an email or any other portal, which gives your site accessibility issues or performance issue as well. Whichever functionalities you want, you can use it. Even you can download Lighthouse desktop versions, which will be there. But as of now, most preferably used by most of the companies as browser extensions. So I'm taking a WCAG name multiple times. So WCAG is the authority, like SEBI in insurance or like TRAI in India is for telecom authority. Similar way, WCAG is when web content protections, which is creating laws for disabled person. And here, if you want, even you can see detailed stats going back to each of the options. It will provide all those details, severity, priority as well. Some of the applications are giving detail about which guidelines it is failing. If you wanted to cover that, let me know in comments. We'll be happy to cover that topic in detail. Other way, if you wanted to learn about WCAG, I'm planning to create a course on accessibility testing, which covers each and everything in detail. If you think this will be interesting, let me know in comment. I will share the course link with you shortly. And this is all about Lighthouse. It's very easy, quick enough to use for any web-based application accessibility testing. That's all for today. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful. Don't forget to share within your circle. Till next time, we'll see you in next video.